It is like farming. Si kitu rahisi. Eh? Wale mlioa juzi kama my nephew hapa. Marriage ni kazi. Na vijana wengi wanapooa, wanapoanza kulima, hata unaweza sikia wakisema, Bishop, yako ni rahisi. Yani wakiangalia Alice na mimi tunaenda, wanasema yako ni rahisi. Karibu umwambie, unataka kuja hapa, nirudi nyuma. Yani nakumbuka wakati tulikuwa tukilima, na umepelekwa shambani na mama, upande wa mama ni kama uko rahisi. Unamwambia mami yako kwako hakuna nini, siku ngumu. Anakupatia hiyo line, eh? Unagonga mara kadhaa na kuja na kuovertake tena. Ni kwa sababu hatukuwa tumezoea, lakini kazi ya kulima ni ngumu sana. Nina rafiki yangu mmoja ambaye alikuwa akituchekelea sana kule Sukari. Kwa sababu sisi tulikuwa na kashamba kamboga. Alafu anakuja yeye ni mtu wa kufanya hesabu, accountants wale mko hapa. Anashika asante. Anashika kalamu, anahesabu. Anasema, kulimisha shamba Bishop ni pesa ngapi? Kuleta hiyo fertilizer kule unaleta gunia mbili ni pesa ngapi? Hiyo maji unamwagilia, pima ni lita ngapi? Alafu ananiambia, anakansa, anasema, na utavuna boga za pesa ngapi? Anakanzo. Sama dige kawira wana. I can't do that kind of business. I would rather go to Githurai and buy. But for you that have those shambas, unakuraga mboga ambayo wewe mwenyewe. Wewe na mkono yako. Wendi unajua maji na kunywa. Yani, ata tunasema hiyo shamba huwa sentimental. Ati watu wakikuja, unawakatia mboga kidogo, unawapatia. Yani, unakatiwa kidogo, unachuniwa, unapewa. Ama ukienda kwa bites, anakukahorera. Mukahoro mmoja anakupatia. And you know, that kind of a thing, it's sentimental in the sense that it is not the serious kind of farming. So when some of us, our marriages sometimes is like that, very sentimental. Which is okay. Because sentimental is expensive. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Sentimental is expensive. The value we put in our sentimental farms are very, very expensive. But going back to what I was talking about, picking field as a way of understanding our marriage as fathers, because God has called us to a business of hard work. I normally say, wedding, people spend so much. Did you know you spend so much on a wedding that if you're not careful, the rest of your life you live murmuring and complaining? It's like, how come we spend all this money and this is not coming? If profit, hakuna faida ina. Because I don't know why you are waiting for profit mwaka ya kwanza, ama ya piri, ama ya tano. Because there are some of us that first year to 5 years, and you still want your marriage to be like mine, and I have struggled. Oh my goodness. Sinime struggle. Ai. Unajua saa shida ni kwa sababu, ukiona kimeundwa. You see, you are good Swahili people. So when you see me, naelea elea. Ni kwa sababu nimeundwa undwa. Nywele ilikuwa nyekundu. Sio kukosa nini. Lakini ni kama inaanza korura. Kwa sababu kuna mtu ambaye anaifanya ielee, ameifanyia kazi. Ninasema hivyo niseme hivi, ndugu ama dada, ukiona dada haja bado, ni kwa sababu hajaundwa. Kazi ya kumuunda ni yako. Mukipendana uanze, Simulisikia vile bishop alituambia hapa Friday. Mimi napendaga hiyo sermon yake sana. Kwa sababu yeye urudia kila mahali ninaenda kwa harusi, yeye urudia. Anasema unapooa mke unayetaka yuko hapa. Hayuko kwa neti. Huyo ako kwa neti ni doro, ni matope. Kazi yako sasa ni kuanza kuunda ile mato. Na ikasemekana hiyo ya jana hakuwa amesema, hiyo ya Friday hakuwa amesema mahali tulikuwa. Akasema matope ya Karatina na matope ya Meru si iko na tofauti? Sio hiyo tu, matope ya Makueni na ya Masako si inakuwa tofauti na ya Masa na ya ta, na ya Kitui? Hata nilitaka kusema nitaka kutumia hawa wawili kwa sababu najua kule wametoka. Ni tofauti. Kuna ingine ni nyekundu, unafikiria ni ile nyekundu ya nini? Na sio hiyo, hiyo ni ya matofali. So udongo ni tofauti. Nikasikia hilo jeno nalo ni la kweli. Kwa hivyo ule udongo umepewa ni tofauti kuliko na udongo wa kwenu. Na huwezi linganisha mtu kwa sababu aumbiki kama yule wa kwenu kwamba yeye hastahili. Ni kujua tu udongo. Bwana asifiwe, udongo. Kwa hivyo unapoanza familia, unajua umepewa udongo, uanze kuunda ule udongo ili ule udongo uwe yule mke ulikuwa umepangia. You know that lady who was an angel. Hasikiagi njaa wakati wote. Ukisema hata achokagi. Eh? Huyo huyo malaika huyo. You have to make this one asichoke. Eh? Do you know when we were getting married, some of us thought a wife is a tractor. Analima. He, the wife is a dry cleaner. Anaosha. He, the wife is production line. Anapata watoto. He, sasa tulikuwa unatafuta mama ambaye hacho. Unaoa mmoja anachoka. Anachoka kwanza. Hey. Baka anakuambia hiyo sahani nimekuletea pale. Wewe huwezi iondoa hapo. Uipeleke hapa. Na mimi nimekupa chakula nayo. You know that kind of a setup. So marriage is like a field. There is a lot of work for it. A sower went to sow out, and when he went to sow out, he had a lot of faith in what he was doing. But he went to sow out. And I said this, and this is what normally sometimes amazes us, and sometimes we miss the point. Farming, where I come from and where you come from, I think farms are the same. There is a kapath, normally, kashamba. And you are told by your parents, wacha kupitia kwa shamba katikati. Sasa. So there is a very hard ground around. Ile munapiga around. Ama kwenu hakuna. Sasa, if you think about that, there is a place that is dry. You also need to know that in some places in our marriage, they are hard. Because we keep on walking on the same spot, so that becomes hard. Nini wewe? Hi jana, hi juzi, hi. And you are stepping on the same. What will happen? It becomes hard. So even when you are throwing seeds of love and concern, they fall on that ground. What happens? They will be gotten out very quickly. Birds will come and snatch them because there is no soil in it. So a family is like shamba. Na shamba ina kazi. Mwambie jirani yako kazi. Tena mwambie kama ni baba ako karibu, mwambie Happy Father's Day. Happy Father's Day. So marriage is hard work. And I normally say marriage has so many seasons. It's like a farm. Sindio? Marriage, men. Marriage has a lot of seasons. Oh my goodness. Are there no seasons? I also discovered marriage has moods. Are there no moods? Oh, I also discovered marriage has a wet season. When everything you throw in is received, everything you throw in germinates, everything you speak out is responded quickly. There are seasons in marriage like those. But I also know there are seasons you throw it in, there is no rain. It needs a lot of prayer for God to bring, first of all, rain, so that that seed that you have thrown down can germinate. Look at the father next to you, tell them Happy Father's Day. Oh, turn to the other one, tell them Happy Father's Day. Now, some of them seated next to you, they are potential. Tell them Happy Potential Fathers. So the text that I have read simply informs us that a sower went to sow. Now, the difference between the farmer here, and it's not a big difference. It's just a matter of these farmers did not have like a small shamba. They had a big one. And if you went with that kapanga kare kadogo, and you are doing like this, ukiangusha angusha mbegu, I mean, you be there for a long time, na mugongo itakuumiza. So this farmer goes standing straight, but he carries his seeds and is throwing them all over. He is throwing them in his shamba. And the Bible records as he throws them, some of them get to that path that has been trodden on many, many, many times. And birds of the air, it doesn't stay long. You know, it's like when, okay, bwana asifiwe. Unapo zeeka zeeka, na kuzeeka nayo iko na scare na iko na baraka zake, sio? One of the barakas unapo zeeka zeeka ni kujua kwamba kuna wakati utasema neno. Samson, umwambie Catherine. Alafu uje after 2 hours, umwambie tena. Catherine, ulisikia vile nilikuambia? Anakuuliza. Uliniambia mimi? Kuna kitu kama hiyo imefanyika. So as you grow in relationship, those things happen and they are so common. Mimi hujaniambia hivyo. So what we have learned with Alice is we don't argue with that statement. We repeat the same thing again. Because you see, as it falls on that hand ground, you've been there, a mother, a father for this long, it is easier for that seed that you thought went in not to have gone in and to have been taken about 2-3 weeks. Sinilikuambia tunaenda kwetu. Unauliza, ati tunaenda kwenu. Uliniambiria wapi? Tulikuwa na nani? Is there any witness? There is no witness. So we say, nisawa tu. Actually, the statement that I hear more often in my places, nisawa tu, lakini sasa tunaweza enda. So that you can do it. So there is a lot of ground around that is hard. There is also some ground that have thorns. You throw it and it doesn't get anywhere. It is up somewhere and there are thorns in it. And in marriage, we have sometimes when things are not right, if you throw it at that time, whatever you have thrown falls on some ground that are thorny. And what thorns do is to choke it. It could have been very nice, but thorns, the idea of thorns is to choke it. And thorns could be things that are coming from all over. Do you know one of the things that I discovered as your pastor is this? And it humbled me. It is this. Si uniambie nikuambie. Nikuambie. Unataka kusikia. I discovered that I'm not the only person who speaks in your life. I discovered that. It humbled me. So when I see you doing certain things, it humbles me. You know? So you can come and give me a testimony like, you know, Bishop, sasa nimepata kitu ingine. Hata nimebadilisha jina. Mimi siitagwe Wainaina tena. Na itagwa Precious Holy Ghost Power Packed Naenda. You know, jata yake wali. It's because I've discovered I'm not the only one. So I salute you. You listen to so many people. You come to this church once and you go to another place. You listen to a radio somewhere, a preacher somewhere. You read certain books, hear certain tapes. So I know there are so many things. And those ones in marriage, sometimes they are thorns. There's something you want to plant, but we heard this. We were told this. I heard this. I read this. And what that does is to choke it. So it doesn't get into the ground. If you're sitting next to a father, please tell them, Happy Father's Day. So the story that we read is a very, Jesus used parables to speak. And I want to say this. There are responsibilities of a farmer just like there are responsibilities of a father. You see, I normally say a coward father is the one who comes to a girl, lies to her. Siraragi nikikufikiria. Wewe ni uwa sijura asubuhi ya majioni. Ata peremende. Wewe ni kiperemende cha kwangu. Yane na kudanganya. Ana kudanganya. Baka nayo sijui. Na wewe kwa ni unakubali kudanganywa hivyo to that level. Na wewe unadanganyika. Unanunuliwa kahawa. Unafanywa mambo mengi. Ata anakuambia, by the way. Ata tukikaa pamoja. Baadaye tutaenda kutafuta certificate huko kwa eji. Sini nakupenda na unanipenda. Na sina mbuzi na ng'ombe ya kupeleka kwenu. Situkae tu. Alafu lo and behold mumekaa. Siku moja unamwambia, by the way, kuna changes imeanza kuhappen. Na una smile ukimwambia, kuna changes imeanza kuhappen. Na ndugu anabadilika uso, anasema, change what? Alafu no, kuna change, unajua sasa sisi wa mama, kuna change. Change nini sema? I'm expecting, enda utoe. You know, then the girl says, afadhali nikae na mtoto wangu. I normally call those people cowards. Anybody who has a child, they lied to that woman, and they are free. I normally call them cowards. Because a courageous man says, kama kimetendeka, bas, ni wangu, eh, bas. Tuende tukakae ngomongo. Tuanze survival. Unanielewa? Kwa hivyo kama hapa kuna baba ambaye ni baba na mtoto na ameanza kukaa mbali na mtoto wake, chukua mtoto wako. Kama ni shida ya mahali kwa kuishi, enda ngomongo, utafuta nyumba ya mabati, kaa pale, anza kulea mtoto wako. Hiyo ndiyo courage. Mwambie kama yuko karibu. Happy Father's Day. There is a lot of work is a response, and the responsibility of a father or a farmer is number one, to plow, then to plant. And plowing is not easy. I know a lot of us want the planting part, but you, before you plant, you have to do the plowing. Plowing is not easy. It's a hard work because some of the ground that you're going to plow has not been plowed before. It's hard ground. You know, ati unambiwa, huyu Esther haku ameolewa mbeleni. Kwa hivyo, wewe usiende kumfanya mke. Kwa sababu huyo mke uko naye ni wa gazeti. Sasa chukua huyu umsaidie kuwa mke. Esther. Wewe ni kibera, ninaongea habari yake. Alafu, Esther, huyu kibera hajaoa. Wewe ndio utakuwa bwana, wewe ndio mke. Wewe ndio utafanya yeye asikiage kama mwanaume. I'm a father. Did you know that? So there is some of us, the responsibility that God has given us, we don't use it well because the responsibility is to make a husband out of that person yandoro we were given. Turn it around. It doesn't matter. Could be a gray one because the soil you got was a gray one. But you just make your gray what? Husband. Make him a gray what? Wife. That's your responsibility. Plowing before you do the planting. And plowing part is hard. You know, the young people that are joining ministry today are a bit lucky, but they are also assuming a lot. You want to become a pastor today and build a church like this one, and you're not even asking, how did we get to where we are? Or you come and you wonder, Bishop, ati umeka hapa miaka ngapi? Sema 34. 34! And this is all what you have been able to do for 34 years. Wait until I come in. 1 year, 2 years, I will have something bigger than this. I wish you well. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord remember you. May the favor of the Lord go before you. But the truth of the matter is, it takes time. There is time involved in it. You have to work on it. And marriage is the same. Marriage is
the same.
Ukiona chaelea. Hey, Peter, si umefanyia Faith kazi. Ama ni Faith amekufanyia kazi. I think Faith ndiye amekufanyia kazi. Vile ninaona hapa. But ukiona chaelea, Samueli, kuna Rebecca mahali. There is someone who has worked on it. And I pray that we don't play then with what another person has worked on. If you've been worked on, then take care. Honor the person who has worked on you to make you the way you are. Plowing is important. And what happens when you are plowing? There will be dust that will fill your eyes. There will be times that your eyes cannot see. There will be foggy. There will be noise that will fill your ears. There will be noise as you do the farming. Sweat will run down your face. You'll have blisters on your hands as you work on the farm. Plows are going to get broken and you'll have to repair them. Sometimes, even in our homes, there are things that are not working. We need to repair them. You'll have bones. Your bones are going to ache with fatigue. You know, sometimes we are carrying one another. I mean, we are heavy people. Can you imagine carrying someone who is 90 kilos? And you carry them every day. And that's what husbands are supposed to do. I can't remember where. Is it here? Maybe it was here. Is it here? Oh, wherever it is. That's the senior moment thing that happens on some of your thinking. I've seen photos and I've envied them. Raphael. Where you get married to Josephine and you lift her, you carry her. Man, I envy those guys. You know what I mean? Because others, you try, mnaanguka nyote. Where did I hear that? Was it here? But the point is, it is hard work. There will be times that you'll be fatigued. You'll be weary. And fathers, we become weary because of the things that we do. And there are some frustration for a farmer, and there are also frustration for fathers. You get frustrated in your marriage, and especially when you're bringing up children. But these are part of plowing. We are working on a ground. We are working on it. But there is something that is crucial for all fathers. Please tell him if he's next to you. Happy Father's Day. There is something that is called perseverance. Fathers are people who persevere. You know, perseverance is key. You know, when we were bringing up our children, we had a very good lady. She's still there. She's a very good lady. I think she should be 70-something now. We loved that. Have you ever seen a couple that you admire them? The way they walk to church. With very disciplined children. Yani unaona tutoto tunafuata dadi vizuri, vizuri, vizuri. Akikaa chini tunakaa vizuri. Hatuna faka faka. Sunday school, wakienda Sunday school, naona wametoka vizuri, vizuri, vizuri. Tutoto tuzu tunafuata na tu. Hey, we observed. Until one day we asked, we thought we would be given a manual of how to bring up disciplined children. Have you ever thought about it? Yani wako mwingine yako juu ya dirisha, mwingine yako juu. Wageni wamekuja na wanyanganya kile wamepewa. Yani unashindwa. Hawa wako, uliwafanya nini? So we wanted... So one day we faced this lady, hoping she would give us a manual. She was the senior librarian at KU those years, in the 70s. So we want help. And then she tells us two things. We wanted to take some notes. And then she said, the first one is called neology. The second one is tocology. And I tell you, we learned. So now what we do and what we have done over the years is to talk and to pray. Have you talked to your teenager girl or boy and you know they are not even listening? Unawapastori lakini wanakucheki, wanauliza, utamaliza lini? Hii msomo, when are you going to finish? So we still remember tokology. Tokology simply means you continue talking. Akiamuka unamwambia sijamaliza, kaa chini. Kwa sababu kitu hatafanya, hata kufanya madharau, ukimwambia akaya ataka. Lakini kusikiza unajua asikizi. Lakini unaongea tu, unaongea tu, unaongea tu, unaongea tu, unaongea tu. Unauliza, newaigua, unaongea tu, unaongea tu, unaongea tu. Umesikia? Unaongea tu, unaongea. Alafu unamwambia, sasa ufanye hivyo. Haongei, ni kama amefura, ni kama amekasirika, ni kama alikuambia tu wewe ukimaliza msomo, ni sawa. So marriage, fathers, happy Father's Day. Fathers, don't forget it is neology and tokology. And you will talk and talk and talk, and sometimes you talk and you wonder, kimbo do you cry? But you keep on talking and talking and talking and talking and talking. Because we were told that is the only thing that can help. Because when they have grown and they are old and they have messed themselves, they will remember one day you did tokology to them. You talked to them. So marriage is like a field. Plowing, there is a lot of hard work to do. How about even to your spouse, both of you? Tokology. Tell them again, happy Father's Day. No, this is their day. So your marriage is going to take some plowing. I pray that God can lift some men here that will say, today, 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 I'll start plowing for my marriage. I will work on it. I'll throw seeds all over. And I'll make sure the ground that I think is hard, I'll start plowing it again and plowing it again so that I can throw in a seed and the seed can germinate. Your children will need cultivating and talking and talking and talking. Because one day they will say something like this. Hey, daddy, si tulikuwa, yani, siju kama hiyo story mtaisikia siku moja. Hey, na daddy, si tulikuwa watukutu. Sasa ndio wataanza kutoa ushuhuda. Si tulikuwa watukutu. It's like you don't know. Si tulikuwa watukutu. Eh, tunarukia huku, ni kama ujui. Na ulijua tu lakini, tokology. Lakini wakafanya wasiki, unarudia, unarudia, unarudia. God help us and have mercy. Your mind and attitude as a father will need to feel that there is a responsibility that you have and you have to keep on plowing the ground. Plowing the ground. Your home will need to have a seed planted and irrigated. Blessed be the name of the Lord. There will be some pain involved in the plowing and planting because sometimes you think nobody heard you. Remember tokology. Nobody heard you, but repeat it again and again. And can I tell you something that you need to underline? Never use the words, see, I told you. Behave like you never told them. Say it again. Now they are the ones that will say, na dadi unarudia hii sana. Let them hear it. But you see, the issue is, no, don't tell them that. See, I told you. No, 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 no. Just go on, go on. Let them be the one that I say, you talk to me, and then you say, I will talk to you until you behave otherwise. So it's like the story of this church that a pastor preached about one sermon for 3 months. Three. Repeating the same sermon. 3 months. And one elder went to him and said, Pastor, kwani unahubiri kitu kimoja? Can I step on some of your toes? Because I also did the same here. Loyalty. Loyalty. And then some people say, e-loyalty, e-loyalty. Be loyal, then we will know we have succeeded. But if you are not, then please allow us to keep on saying about it. Tokology. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Until it sinks. So we'll keep on saying it. Amen. Ni sawa, eh? So there are 3 things that you as a father and a farmer have to agree to do. Number one, there is something that we call the wayside. I told you, because you are not the only, you know also it will be ridiculous for you as a man to think your wife only reads you, hears you, only? No, they meet with other ladies, they talk.
She is a counselor. She counsels others. There is a lot of things that happen. So you might throw in a word which does not get to the ground. The way is hard. And this is the ground that becomes hard and packed down because of the constant traffic along the edges of the field. Busyness, hurry, sometimes simple responsibility in life will cause this ground not to bear fruit. Before the seed ever really has the opportunity to take root, the birds have come by, devoured the seed. Therefore, guard you yourself as a father, becoming so busy that robs your God and your family. Because then you blame yourself when it doesn't work the way you want. The thorny ground, and I talked about it a little bit, the thorny ground, it cannot get in because there is this information and that information. This is the ground that comes about by the trappings of materialism. 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 Pressure that we put into one another. And you know, sometimes even you can tell your husband this. Where do she ragia? You don't think like other men. Now, there are some men that have stolen money from National Youth Service because of pressure, so that they can think like other men. But today, where are they? Yeah? So those are the questions that we need to ask, so that this thorny ground will be careful, so that we don't push each other. You know? You saw and so alihama alienda Ridgeways. Ridgeways iko watu. Nilikuambia udongo, udongo ni nyingi. Kuna udongo ya Karati na udongo ya Muranga. Na yule wa Karati lazima aunde udongo ya Muranga. Ili iwe udongo ule anatakaga. Na ya udongo ya Muranga nayo iunde. Yaani ni kuundana. We are all there in the business of undana. Kuundana. Bwana asifiwe. And even you fathers that feel like you are not fathers enough because your wife earns more than you. Remember, you are the father. Remember, you have to do the plowing. Na wewe dada wacha kufinyiria. You know, if you came to the wedding here on Friday, maybe you left here saying, jikarira na ujikarira wega, nani guikarira na guikarira wega. That was the sermon. The sermon was, you agree. On this part, nikalie. Unajua ile wimbo tunasemaga umenifanya chijui chapati sijui nini. Yani unasema pande hii nikalie sawa sawa kama chapati vizuri. Na pande hii unikubalie nikukali. Kuna area lazima wazee mkaliwe. Na wa mama kuna area lazima mkali. Kwa hivyo ukiambiwa umekaliwa. Sasa tukiambia, we kadhi umekaliwa sana na huyo mzee. You don't react. You say, kwa haya menikalia kwanza ni mimi nilimwambia pande hiyo akalie. Kabisa. Eh? Na wazee wakiambiwa wamekaliwa na mama. Kwanza anasema, mimi, getonga, kuma miru. So the point is this, that you and I know there will be thorny, those thorny, thorny issues. Let's not materialize, trappings come and you know, pursuit of money and the niceties of life at the expense of your God and your family. Fathers, don't allow that. Tell him Happy Father's Day. I hope he's getting, he should be happy, even with all this information. The stony ground, this is the ground that is accompanied by certain hardness of heart. The stony ground is marked by apathy. Yan, you are there, and maybe your family, and you live in apathy. May God help us. The prayer is that, may all the fathers that are listening to me be crying fathers that will cry with their knees as they pray and agonize for their children. Because you know what? All of us were teenagers one day. Tell the guy next to you, hata wewe ulikuwa teenager. Na umuangalie vizuri mwambie, kwanza vile na kuangalia, ulikuwa sugu. Yeah. You know, sometimes we behave like we were not teenagers. But I tell you what, I was. So sometimes I have to know when I have teenagers in the house. Now I don't. I have no teenagers in the house. But I'm saying when I had teenagers in the house, now I have to know how to behave. One time in my house, I had four of them. Four. Two of my own and two of my friends. And I tell you, teenagers can make you stand always, actually on your toes, because there are different soils and different fibers and so on. They would make you stand. One time I'm even asking them. It is morning and I'm taking them to school. Two, I'm dropping in Alliance. One, I'm dropping at Nairobi. Another one at Sunshine. And they are there. Nawauliza, mnataka tu kunikasirisha? Mumeamua leo. Leo mumeamua. Leo mumeamua. But you see what? Hata nikikasirika, ni mimi nitawapeleka wapi? Shule. Kwa sababu, we care for our children so much. Nilisema hivi kwa ibada ya kwanza ama hii. Kwamba, wakati wetu, na wengine ni wakati ile zetu, ulikuwa unachapwa sokoni. Umebisbehave wapi? Sokoni. Si kwenu, sokoni. Unachunwa. Unakimbia, mami nimechunwa, mami, anakuchuna. Unakimbia, dadi nimechunwa, anakuchuna. Na sasa wako wakichunwa. Unakuja Cornerstone ukitafuta mwalimu. Mtu anatusaidia ni askari, anakupoza poza kidogo. Lakini bado unahema hema. Ukiwacha askari unauliza, darasa ni gani? Which class is it? Which unaambiwa, no, you don't go to class, you go to the head teacher's office. Sasa kwa head teacher kuna kuwa na mungangano. Why mtoto wangu alichunwa? Hata utaki kujua alichunwa kwa nini? The fact is, alifanywa nini? Chunwa. Huwezi mchuna. Hautaki kujua kuna tabia mbaya. Huwezi. So, what type of children do we have? How? Unamleta Sunday school, unataka walimu wa Sunday school, wampe nidhamu. Dakika thate. Si ataimba Jesus loves me na akitoka tamtukana mtoto mwingine pale wakienda nyumbani. Umetuletea mtoto tu masaa manane, mchana. Na unataka akirudi kwako awe malaika. Ebu niseme hivi. Fathers that are here. This is a Father's Day. So fathers, remember, it is work. We have to plow the ground. We have to work with our children. And you children, hata mkisikia nimewatetea sana, mjue kuna baraka unaweza hepa. Ukiwa nawe umejifanya atimawe. Najua mimi dadia napiga kelele na muangalia tu. Haya. Mama yetu alikuwa akisema hivi, ugokerio ni maku. For those that never got that joke, is very powerful. So you are told by your parents to wake up. Unaringa ringa. Anakuambia lala tu, lala tu. Siku moja, yako itakuamusha. Nimeamushwa na yanani leo? Sini yangu. Wewe umeamushwa na yanani? Sini yako. Kesho utaamushwa na yanani? Sini baba yako atakuwa pale? Na baba atakuwa pale? So you, we have amuka, jifundisha mapema. Bwana Yesu apewe sifa. Fadhali kumaliza. Weeding. A farmer has a time for weeding. We need to weed. A farmer understands how crucial it is to make sure that the weeds do not corrupt and strive for the crop. The farmer understands there is great power that comes from the soil. The farmer understands the soil will grow anything. And I want you to tell the father next to you, Father, know this. Father, know this. In your family, it is the soil, and it can grow anything. Now, may it sober your mind. Yani huko kunaweza ota mwizi, mukora, murogi, mchawi. Yeah, the soil is there. It can grow anything. So what is my responsibility? Is to make sure none of those. So I have to be there so that I can weed. And remember what I say, tocology. I have to keep on, you know, because anything can grow. Now, when it grows, makwekwe, maeto makwekwe, ama ni kwekwe. Basi yo kwekwe, haikuwagu kwekwe, inakuwaga makwekwe, yani ni twig. There are so many. They grow so many. You plant, and you know when you used to go to farm with my mother, ati kulimia. Kwa sababu kulimia ni kazi, bwana asifiwe. Si kulimia ni kazi. Ati upindu, ulimia hiyo mahindi vizuri uwache peke yake. Sasa hili tumaliza upesi. Bwana asifiwe. Tunalima hata hiyo ilikuwa. Tunaenda hili tu.
Sasa mama anakuambia, saka ugikiri hati ya we, umelima hata mahindi. Mahindi, alafu nauliza, kwani mahindi ni gani? Yani, it's like you are behaving like you don't know.
May God help us as fathers. We know that there is something that we need to pull out. Because anything can grow.
Na usiulize imeota kwa nani, hata kwako. Ni soil.
And anything can grow. Anything can grow.
Wacha nimalize. Niseme, kuna mahali pengine itahitaji irrigation. Mwambie jirani yako irrigation. Yani irrigation. Kwa sababu, maji yameisha. Maji hakuna. The natural,
you know there are some things that come naturally. Natural things are not coming. You are not loving each other naturally. You have to mwagia maji.
Na kumwagia maji ni kwenda seminar, tunaambiwa shikaneni mikono, mnashikana. Mnaambiwa sijui endeni mmeshikana mikono, mnatoka pale kimekauka lakini mnashikana mikono. You know, mnashikana mikono. You know, ama unaenda kwa harusi, unasikia ka salmon, mkitoka pale mnaambia ndwaigwa wewe igitoro. Bas, allow me to mold you. No, and so on. So you, it's like
those are the places that it helps you so that you can keep yourself in it. It's like you go there for irrigation. May God help us to go for irrigation when it is dry. Don't die alone. Go for irrigation. And irrigation could also mean asking for counsel and wisdom. What am I supposed to do here? When you feel a burden to fast for your children, that is irrigating them. You want to pray and fast for your crop for tomorrow. You are fasting and praying for your children. That is irrigating. When you begin to dig into the word of God, you are irrigating them for tomorrow and yourself for tomorrow. When you seek wise counsel before making decisions, you're also doing the same because harvest is coming. Harvest is coming. Harvest is coming. You know, I'll be a successful father when my son succeeds as a father. We will be successful parents when Nyambura and her children succeed. And we pray that they will succeed when we are around here. You know, so that we can see. So unaona hiyo ni miaka 120. Ili uweze kusucceed. But there are some of us, we give up so quickly. Remember tokology. Keep on talking. Eh? Na wengine muliongea, tukaongea, na wakaendelea wakiharibika, usife moyo. Hata ukiona saa hii, ongea. Kuna dada moja, akija kufariki hospitalini. Walipo kuja kumuona, aliambia mama yake hivi. Mimi, hata nikipotea, niende jehenamu. Wewe sita kulaumu mama. Kwa sababu, umenizungumzia. Umeniambia. Si afadhali tuendelee kuambia watoto wetu. Bwana asifiwe sana. I want to give. Hapana. Hebu niseme kama yule mtu alisema. Imesema stop. Na ni nyekundu. Sinimalizie pale. Happy Father's Day. Oh, turn around to another father. Happy Father's Day. Happy Father's Day. Our prayer today is for fathers. If you're a father, stand up on your two feet. If you're a father, stand on your two feet. If you're a potential father, stand on your two feet. Wow. Yes, I can see the potentials who are more. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And then the other group I'll tell you, but we'll start with the fathers. Heavenly Father, I want to thank you for the fathers in this house standing today. Lord God, indeed, it is hard work to be a father because, Lord God, you call them to plow, to prepare the ground, to put up seed, to weed them up, to irrigate where necessary, and to wait for the harvest. I pray, dear Father, that these fathers that are standing, they will be fathers of perseverance. They will persevere even the challenges that their children grow to. They start with small angels. These angels grow to places where they ask questions that are so deep. And finally, they don't want to ask anything. They know all. But Lord, we pray that the fathers in the house will kneel and pray before the Lord God Almighty so that their children can become what they desire them to be in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. If there is any father that has had left, had felt frustrated, had almost given up, Lord, we pray that from this point, they will rise up and take their rightful position as fathers to pray and talk about the things that they believe in. If there are fathers that are left to the ground and there is a lot of weeds, I pray, dear Father, you will help them to know what to do so that they can spread the weeds and all the weeds can fall down in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God, we pray that the fathers in this house, the fathers that have listened to me, Lord God, they will know that they can learn a lot from the field about themselves as fathers. We honor you and we give you thanks. For this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. I want to ask all the sons and daughters of the house. You are a teenager. Stand up. Let the father sit. If you're a teenager, just stand up. Teenagers, just stand up. Hallelujah. You're a wonderful people, teenagers. Bwana asifiwe. We know wakati mwingine hata mkithomerwa mnakaa tu ngumu. We know. But it is for a short season. Imagine teenager ikaagi mirere. Lakini ukikataa kuchunga inaweza kukusumbua hata ukiwa 50. So you have to handle it quickly. You know? Whatever you want to learn, you learn quickly so that you leave that group and move into something else. And that is the kind of prayer that I want to pray for you. Heavenly Father, I want to pray for the teenagers that are standing. This is a wonderful group of people. Our church will prosper out of these teenagers. Lord God, these are the evangelists. These are the doctors. These are the bishops. These are the pastors. These are the nurses. These are the teachers, engineers, pilots. These are the people that will turn Kenya upside down. These are the people that will change their families. They are going beyond where their fathers went. And therefore, Father, we pray that this period of time, they will not allow it, dear Father, to stay so much in them. But they will learn what they can learn quickly, be obedient children, and allow their parents to weed around so that they will grow the way God you want them to grow. And when this season is over, they will mature into the next level because seasons are important for them in this life. Those that are in school, we pray they will excel in their studies. They will not engage themselves with something that is outside. Lord God, they will not try to learn tricks that will jeopardize them. They will not try to do things that will hurt them. But dear Father, in this period, I pray for a cover upon them in the mighty name of Jesus. Those that are disobedient, we pray they will turn back to you. Dear Lord, that they will ask for forgiveness to their parents. And dear Lord, they will move into the next level in the mighty name of Jesus. Those, dear Father, are just about to do their exams. We want to pray they will do well. Because Lord, from today, they are walking in a different avenue. They are walking, allowing to be weeded so that they can become the kind of persons that you want them to be. As a father, I want to bless them, the blessing of a father, in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And everybody say, amen. Let's give the Lord praise in the house.